Let's pray. Our Father in heaven, please give us wisdom and understanding to understand your word as we open your word. Please be with us, Son of the Holy Spirit, so that we can be more like you, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Happy Sabbath, bro. I am happy to be here because this is a Seventh-day Adventist church. And I know you believe, even if I already don't know you, we have 28 things that unite us together. Amos 3:3 says, can two walk together unless they be agreed? So since we're all Seventh-day Adventists, at least we unite in 28 things. Number one, we all believe the Holy Scriptures. Because that is the basis of our unity, our basis of our practices, the basis of this church, this organization, this denomination, and our institutions, and all our doctrines are based in this Bible. This is also the difference between the true church and the not true church, because our doctrines are pure. When we say pure, all of them can be proven positively from the Bible. The faith church makes more important their traditions and their practices to defend them, even if it's not in the Bible. And that is the contradiction between the pure woman, when Jesus will come, he will come for the pure church, characterized by biblical doctrines, and in contrast with the harlot woman, who doesn't, they don't care so much the biblicalness of their doctrines. And that is based on Isaiah 8:20, which says to the law and to the testimony, if they speak not according to his word, it is because there is no light in them. So when they say to the law, that includes laws of the lands, laws of the school, laws of the company, laws of the house, laws of relationships, laws of the church, para kanino ba yan, kundi para sa atin. It includes everything. And this testimony includes reports, kwento, mga panaginip ko no, at saka kung ano pa. We are going, even experiences, we are going to filter them through the biblical purity. And if they don't speak according to the word, if they don't speak according to the word, it is brown out. There is no light in them. Ano po ang ibig sabihin ng according? Sa Tagalog po yan ay sangayon. Merong ibang version nitong verse text na to. Masyadong pababa kasi yung low. Merong ibang version nitong text na to na medyo some people get challenged understanding. Sabi nila, to the law and to the testimony, if they don't contradict the Bible, there is no light in them. Pareho po ba yun ng according at saka non-contradiction? Hindi. Halimbawa. So, kailangan, ang law and the testimony ay according. Ibig sabihin, ayon. Halimbawa, sinabi ko, pagkatapos ng araw worship, ako ay pupunta dun sa morning view. Pero sabi ng iba, sabi daw ni Sir Win, pagkatapos ng araw worship, siya daw ay pupunta sa morning view, pero dadaan ko na siya sa AUP. Yun po ba ay according sa akin? Eh, hindi. Hindi. Yun po ba ay nag-contradict sa sinabi ko? Hindi. Hindi rin. Pero, ang pinaka-safe ay yung according. Diba? Yung sinabi ng Bible, yun yun. Pag merong hindi sinabi yung Bible, hindi yun according. Diba? Halimbawa, huwag kang manigarilyo. Sabi ba ng Bible, huwag manigarilyo? Hindi. Pero, sabi ng Bible, ay hindi tayo manigarilyo. Sabi ba ng Bible, huwag tayo mag-baptize ng infants? Hindi ko lang alam. Pero wala pa akong natagpuan. Sabi ko sa Bible, huwag tayo mag-baptize ng bisik-bisik. Ba't di natin ginagawa? Hindi naman sinabi ng Bible na bawal mag-baptize ng bisik-bisik at saka ng infants. So, ang doctrines ng Adventist ay hindi galing sa kung anong hindi sinabi ng Bible. Ang doctrines ng Adventist Church ay galing sa kung anong sinabi ng Bible. Yan. Must say yung malinaw na thus saith the karon, sabi sa Great Controversy, our demand for every present and doctrine, our demand should be a clear, thus said the Lord. Ayon, in Tagalog, according sa English. In other words, it should be advertised positively in the Bible, it should be taught positively in the Bible, and it should be promoted or commanded positively in the word Bible. Hindi na yun ibig sabihin na si Solomon maraming asawa yung kaasawa tayo ng marami. Dahil yun ay hindi positively nilagay sa Bible. It has a negative example. So yun po ang ibig sabihin na according. That is the safety of the Adventist Church. That all the doctrines are according and are supposed to be according. Kaya lang yung iba, sabi nila, hindi naman pinagbabawal ang ganito sa Bible. Hindi naman namin makita na bawal ito sa Bible. Pwede namin gawin. Hindi, ganun ang doctrines natin mga kaibigan. Ang doctrines namin ay according. Saan galing? Kay Servin. Hindi. Sabi ng Isaiah. Yan ang sabi ng Isaiah. The safety is in the accordingness. Si Cain, sinabi ba ng Diyos, huwag kang mag-over ng vegetables? Wala tayong document. Hindi natin alam. Hindi natin mapatunayan. Pero ang sabi ng Diyos, ang i-offer mo ay lamb. Hindi naman sabi ni Cain siguro, hindi naman sinabi ng Diyos, bawal mag-over ng vegetables. Yung hermeneutic na yun, mali yun mga kaibigan. Yung pag-aaral ng Biblia na yun ay mali. Hindi lahat ng hindi sinasabi ng Bible pwede natin gawin. Alam niya, ini-emphasize ko ito dahil lahat ng susunod dito, nakadepende dito. Lahat ng doctrines natin, practices na legal, dyan nakadepende. Okay. And dyan din, nakita niyo yung baptism, pagbisik-bisik at saka infant baptism, hindi sinasabi ng Bible, bawal gawin. Hindi natin ginagawa dahil hindi siya according. Okay. Kasi maraming naguguluhan dyan. Sabi nila, okay, ulit-ulit na sabi ko. Trinity. Nasa Bible pa yan. Ang Trinity po ay English na word. Ibigisan ko ang salita ko kasi mag-finish nyo yung class. English na word ang Trinity. At yung anti-Trinitarian, English din na debate. Bakit? Pumunta tayo sa Tagalog. Wala naman Trinity sa Tagalog. Di yung anti-Trinitarian, English debate lang yun. But the words describe ideas. And ideas, yung Trinity, harapin nyo pa sa Greek na Bible at sa Hebrew na Bible. Kung makita nyo. Wala. But the ideas, the concept, sabi ni Pastor Parola sa English, the concept is there. Words describe ideas. And ideas help us understand the concepts. And kung ano yung nakasabi sa Bible, kahit hindi natin maintindihan ang kabuuhan ng nature ng Diyos dahil we are limited, God is unlimited, kung ano yung nakasabi sa Bible, yun na yun. Diyan ang sinasabi ng Bible. And kasama diyan ang God the Father, God the Son, became Jesus Christ, and the Holy Spirit, who is teaching us all things. The Holy Spirit inspired the Bible writers, inspired Ellen G. White, inspired the young people to go evangelism, inspired the old people to support, inspired you to come to church, to believe the Bible, to take Christian education, and to sing good songs. And the Holy Spirit and Jesus said, I am going, but I will send a comforter who will teach you all things. So the Holy Spirit is teaching us all things whatsoever Jesus has taught them. But if Jesus left, how can Jesus teach? Just the revelator, the revelation of Jesus Christ. Of course, through the Holy Spirit, the message comes from the Father, signatured by Jesus Christ, and then through the Holy Spirit impressed to John the Revelator, and therefore he wrote the revelation of Jesus Christ. Therefore, whatever prophecy comes, if it is according to the word, it is from Jesus Christ. And kasama dyan, ang trabaho ng Holy Spirit, including the spirit of prophecy, is from Jesus Christ. Through the Holy Spirit, from Jesus Christ. So the spirit of prophecy explains prophecy. Di ba mas madaling maintindihan ang Bible kung may great controversy? Of course, we believe creation. If you have any challenge in creation, just we can watch I attended an IAS theological forum on creation. It's about 4 days of videos from Adventist scholars about creation. But we don't have challenge on that, and we will skip for time. Nature of man, we were created perfect, but because of disobedience, we fell. But there is a plan of salvation to restore us to the original nature. And we have the great controversy. Mabuti na lang, Jesus said in the cross, it is finished. In effect, the result of the great controversy is already finished. Praise the Lord. We are assured when we are in God's side that we are going to win with Him. So, hindi na tayo matatakot, but we still have to live the remnant mission. And of course, we believe that Jesus really lived in earth. Bakit? Sabi 2014. Ano saan galing yung 2014? Sa 1. 2013 pa atras. Ano yung isang 2014? 2014, approximately, from the time Jesus Christ was around. Therefore, there is no atheist calendar. Diba? Bakit sabi nila 2014? 2014 from where? From Jesus Christ. Kaya, hirap-hirap yung atheist doon. Tingnan lang nila kalendar nila. It is true, Jesus Christ lived in earth, and it is true, He died for our sins. Praise the Lord. An atonement and appropriation, substitutionary, expiatory, reconciling, and transforming. Dahil, because we understand how God loves us, we don't want to sin again. When we understand God's suffering for us, how He saved us while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. When we understand that the penalty of sin is death, when we understand all of these things, we are not comfortable anymore to continue sinning. That is the changing power of the life, death, and resurrection. And God, Jesus Christ, did not only die, He resurrected. If Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, can resurrect Himself, then He can also resurrect us. Therefore, our loyalty is not on our fraternity who cannot wake us up from the dead, not on worldly organizations, not on money, not even on family, but on Jesus Christ. Because Jesus Christ only can restore our life if and when we die. Therefore, the biggest power dun tayo mag higing royal. Jesus Christ resurrection. Okay. And we also believe in the experience of salvation. When baptism comes, God forgives all our sins, justification. And then we continue to live the sanctification life. God is correcting us. God is revealing to us our sins. We repent. God forgives us. And we grow and grow. And finally, the end is glorification. And the miracle of salvation is the greatest testimony and miracle that our church can have. We have many people who are criminals who are now good. For example, Moses. He used to kill the Egyptian. He ran away. And somehow, God saved him. Not only saved him, He gave him the opportunity to carry the Ten Commandments from Mount Sinai. Nakasulat doon, thou shalt not kill. Hindi ba kumarap na lang ang Diyos na hindi nakapatay? Para kumarap na ng Ten Commandments. But God forgives. When you pray for forgiveness, according to Ellen G. White, that is the most priority prayer that God answers. When you pray for forgiveness, He erased the sin as if you are clean again. Though your sins be as scarlet, they shall make them as white as snow. Si Pablo, nagpe-persecute, nagpapatay, nag-organize ng persecution according to the Christians. But when God called him, he wrote almost half of the New Testament books, and he himself was persecuted. So, yung mga nagpe-persecute sa atin, bayaan nyo lang. Pag tinawag niya ng Diyos, magbabago. Makapangyarihan mo ang salita ng Diyos. And growing in Christ, even if you were baptized already, we read the Bible 2 times, 3 times, 4 times, we have still to read and read the spiritual prophecy and grow, because there is no end to the perfection that God wants us. There is no end there's no limit to what God can do with us. And we are not afraid of evil forces, aswang, yung ganyan-ganyan, because Romans 8, 35 to 30, 41 says, nothing can separate us from the love of God, neither death nor life nor angels nor principalities nor things present nor things to come, nor height nor depth, any other creature shall be able to separate us from the love of Christ. So, hindi tayo matatakot, pag nakapanood tayo ng Illuminati kuno, ng mga ganto, persecution, we are not supposed to be afraid, because nothing can separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord. And we also believe in the church. The church from Adam, everybody who believes in Jesus Christ, genuinely believes in Jesus Christ, is actually an Adventist. You can call them Seventh-day Adventist. And, yan. Okay. We also believe in the remnant and its mission. Maraming remnant. Sa Bible, when nagkasala ang mga tao, Noah was called as the remnant. Sinong nauna? Si Noah, si Abraham. Parang si Abraham. Si Noah. So, nung nagkasala ulit mga anak ni Noah, si Abraham was called out. Nung nagkasala ang mga Israelites, no. When they were put in Egypt, they were called out again. And then when the Israelites started to worship idols, they were remnanted again. When the Israelites crucified Jesus, there was another remnant, Christians. When the Christians started to believe more traditions than the Bible, there was the Protestants. And the Protestants supposed to grow in Christ, but they stuck there where they are. And guess who is the remnant who continued in the progressive revelation? Of course, the Seventh-day Adventist Church. Question, will there be a new remnant? Okay, our friends in IAS seminary studied that. And then the dean made a paper about that. And he said, we cannot find it in the Bible. And the SLP says that this church, even if there are leaders in this church, because this is a church militant, not yet a church triumphant, we are still fighting. God will set everything in order and making adjustments if needed in the head of the world. So if leaders, if you are a leader, you don't want to follow, God will adjust you according to SLP. Will adjust maybe the position or the people. But surely there will be a church, a woman, when Jesus Christ comes, who will be pure. All doctrines are biblical practices. How about the people who don't want to follow? And John also says, the faithful will be the church, will become the church triumphant. And the sinners in Zion will be sifted out. Oh, huwag tayong lalabas sa Adventist Church dahil sinners daw yung lumalabas. Ayaw magtayo. Yun. Yun po ang sabi sa kasulatan natin. And we are not just remnant, just for becoming remnant, we have a mission. Which is Revelation 14, to tell the world to worship, and to repent, and to reform. And we are united. Some people are good in singing, some people are good in computer, some people are good in smiling, some people are good in preparing food, some people are good in gift of health. Ito yung aking gift of health. I help for you, June. I help. This ministry, I help. And by helping, you are happy. It's boring if there is nothing to do. So we unite and we do evangelism, and that's our mission. And of course, baptism, of course, biblical baptism, according. Not because, okay, we discussed that already. We also do and believe the Lord's Supper because Jesus Christ said so. And of course, the spiritual gifts, the same thing, there are many spiritual gifts, administration, reconciliation, compassion, self-sacrificing service, like Maubus Nampera, lang, tulong lang ang tulong sa gawain. That is a gift, my friend. Evangelism, etc. Gift of prophecy, because Joel 2:28 says, and the time will come when young men shall see visions, dreams, and the Spirit of the Lord shall depart out of all flesh, and then he shall prophesy. And appeared in Acts 2:14-21, the same paragraphs, pero may dinagdag in the last days. Same paragraph. Appeared in Old Testament and in New Testament. That's why maraming voice of youth. Maraming evangelistic crusade. Dito. At saka kung saan-saan. It is a fulfillment of prophecy. So many shall prophesy. When you say Jesus is coming soon, that is a prophecy. And you are prophesying. So all Adventists are supposed to be prophets. There are big prophets, there are small prophets. But the Bible says, you should prophesy. Okay, law of God, 10 commandments. We memorize that, and I want to emphasize things that we are not very familiar with. Thou shalt not kill, meaning you should not say bad things. Thou shalt not steal, you should be good at samples, and thou shalt not steal. That's why we don't sell off the books that the enemies are selling, diba? Kasi rockstar natin yung libro ng AD para hindi mahal. You don't do that. You have to be good example. Diba? Kasi lang yung copyright. You know what copyright means? You cannot copy. Only PPAs can copy. O, diba? Alam natin, masakit kung tayo na pinaghanakawan. Pero pag civil case na ang pinaparate natin yung software, hindi natin naiintindihan. Kasi ako lang ang software developer siguro dito at saka yung Sir Goods. Diba? Pero ilagay natin sa books, maintindihan natin. Hindi mabubuhay ang literature ministry if you don't respect copyright laws. Laws of the land to respect writers and publishers. That's why we are not supposed to pirate DVDs, boobies, MP3s, pictures. Yung good sort, Adventist din may aran yan. Okay. And most importantly, according to Brother Sadul, Sadul ba yung vendor? Tama yung kanyang mga niluluto na hindi nagluluto pag Sabado. Because according to the Bible, do not cook manna. Sieve what thou wilt sieve, boil what thou wilt boil. According to SOP, of course, if you research the whole Bible for cooking on Sabbath, you will not find anybody cooking except the priest. So, even in the New Testament, they were not cooking. You cannot find proof. How about in SOP? Does the Sabbath observance change? No, the law doesn't change. The Ten Commandments doesn't change. Not cooking is still not cooking, even if you don't understand. Of course, the challenge is you learn not talk. Because teaching this is hard. You will lose popularity. People might not put in position. People might not get me, I don't care. I will teach straight. Whatever is there, is there. The spirit of prophecy says we should avoid cooking on Sabbath. We should avoid, we should shine our shoes before Sabbath, ironing our clothes, etc. The Adventist.org, our official website of the Seventh-day Adventist Church, says nothing about cooking. But they made it wider. It says, buying and preparation of food should be done before the Sabbath. Kasama na dun ang microwave. Para sa sabi niya, hindi naman ang papanggatong yung microwave. Kindle na naman ang kindle. Full Sabbath, I will microwave. Hindi ba yun? Kaya sabi, buying and preparation of food. Dati kami-kami lang nag-i-page ito at yung mga kaibigan ko. Kaya kung kumakaming stream. Pero, God is restoring the truth to the church. I attended the International Student Services Conference at IAS, by God's grace. And, one of the presidents of UNCLUB, Universitas UNCLUB, an Adventist University in Indonesia, the president has a PhD in New Testament. He's very strong guy. Sabi niya, in our campus, we cook all our viands before Sabbath. Cafeteria. So, kung may, if there's a wind, there is a way. Except the rice. So, somebody from Thailand, our SSO from Buaklek, the small elementary school, she's a black woman. I don't understand. What's wrong with you Asians? Why can't you cook your rice on Friday? Why do you have to make it fresh? So sabi ko, ang problem, hindi lang para sa Philippines. Sa Indonesia, medyo problem din. But somebody is pushing there, somebody is strong. Sa Thailand, problema rin. But if you look at the Bible, the SOP, Adventist.org, they are all aligned. Of course, Adventist.org cannot do anything that is not right. So, anong solution? Education. We have to teach what is true, and those who love God will follow. Those who don't love God, they hope they don't understand what they are teaching, or they are not in church. But you know, the Sabbath is the most important test of loyalty to God. It is the seal of God, this is the sealing time, and God is making sure, we have to make sure the seal of God is clear. In the last statements, which I'm going to open later, it says, we should guard the edges of the Sabbath. Yeah. Conscientious Sabbath observance is one of the characteristics of last day people. Conscientious Sabbath observance. We have to educate this, even if we were not taught correctly, because many excuses, there is an opinion. Mahirap daw kasi magpapuy ng apoy nung panahon ni Ellen G. White. Hinahanap ko yan mga kapatid sa Bible, wala akong makitang ganyan. Sa SOP, wala rin akong makitang ganyan. Sa Adventist.org, sa BRI, wala rin akong makita. Anong gagawin ko? Kung ano lang masulat doon, yun ang isasabi ko. Bahala kayo kung anong gusto niya gawin sa akin. Basta, yun po ang nakasulat at yun ang sasabihin ko. Ang challenge sa atin, alam ko mga kapatid, gusto niyong sumunod. Kasi mahal tayo ng Diyos. Ano pa bang mahirap kung kumpara sa kaligtasan? Kulang pa ba ang kaligtasan para tayo sumunod? Hindi. Kung maintindihan natin ang kalakihan ng kaligtasan ng Diyos para sa atin, walang mahirap. Hindi lang natin alam kung paano kasi namapanis yung ating mga tao. Ay, binibigyan tayo ng example. So, example sa Auckland Universitas, they can prove all their bias. Yung cafeteria yun, ha? Mass production yun. Sa Thailand, sabi ko din sa... So, they can cook even the rice before Sabah. There is example. Tapos, I was wondering, praying to God, is this really true? I am not comfortable because maybe it's hard for many people to listen to this message. So, doon ako sa CIS, nagtuturo ng Sabah school. Sabi ng asawa ng Vice President for Student Services, Wim, you know, one of our teachers from Dagam, Ma'am Habla, when she retired, she served as a volunteer missionary in some islands in the Pacific, and she was the matron in the camp. And there is, they successfully avoided cooking on Sabbath. They put their food, they dug a hole in the ground, they put the food there, and it was warm until the Sabbath. So, kung kailangan nag-hukay, nag-hukay. Sabi naman ng iba, effort yan, sir. Kasi mahirap ang effort dati ng baboy. Pero ang argument ko, ang Diyos, when He created the earth, almost no effort, voice command lang, let there be like this, let there be like this. And on the seventh day, God said, let there be food. Hindi. When did He say, let there be food? Before even creating the human, the food was there already. So even if God can effortlessly create food, He did not let them put on the Sabbath day, because He wants to be a good example for all of us. Another problem with that understanding is, Ellen G. White says, it is not God's will that His children eat cold food on the Sabbath. So you can warm the food. Very good. Pwede tayo magpapoy for warming. Ang tanong, ang effort ng pagpapoy for cooking at effort ng pagpapoy pag-warming halos pareho. Yung dami lang ng paggatong ang difference. Therefore, hindi yung effort ang problema. Bakit? Sabi ni Ellen G. White, you can warm. E magpapapoy ka rin. Why can you warm? And why can you not cook? The difference between warm and cook is the temperature. Diba yung rice cooker? Pag naka-warm. Pag naka-cook, ganun. Ang isa ba doon? Yung pinigunin yung cook. O yung microwave, may cook din, may warm. Diba? The seal of God has to be clear. Last day, Ellen says, the last day before we have conscientious Sabbath keepers. Sabbath observers. Meron pang isa, sa Adventist that our guidelines on keeping the Sabbath says, non-religious activities, traveling towards non-religious activities should not be, the hours of the Sabbath should not be spent on traveling, going to secular activities on Sabbath night. So pag merong ano ba yan? Mga party, paggabi. Tapos, nag-iwahanda na kayo ng damit pag sabi rin ng hapon, kung may JS, kung may kung ano. Hindi yun dapat. Hindi niya alam, kaya hindi niya sinasunod. Pero ngayon alam niya, nakalangin ko yung makasunod. Of course, Pastor Coach and Pastor Manny Reyes, they were very positive about this one. That's nice, because Sabbath is a blessing. We have to be balanced when we present. But I have to present the things that are not yet presented. Okay, to make it all balanced. Because that's what the Bible says, SOP affirms, Adventist that all teaches. But in the Philippines, we have a challenge. We have to fill up the challenge. Okay. Of course, we spend all our influence, resources, and the more you finish your money in God's work, the sweeter your religious experience, your spiritual experience. And Christian behavior, we don't go watch boxing. We don't watch fiction. We don't read fiction. We don't watch advertisements that are not pure. We don't watch Showtime in Bulacan because the dress is not pure. It influences our youth. We don't watch telenovela because it's fiction. Why? Where in the Bible is the proof? It's here in Philippians 4:8. Whatsoever is true, binabasa yung fiction. Therefore, fiction is not according to the Bible. Whatsoever is pure, honest, just, lovely, etc. Think of these things. If we are watching it, it comes to our mind. Therefore, we are thinking about it. So let us close our eyes from seeing evil. Close our ears from hearing evil, according to the Bible. Mabuti na lang, merong Bible, hindi magugulo ang mga tahanan. Dahil sabi sa Bible, wives, submit to your husbands, and husbands, submit unto them. Love your wives as God loves the church. And children, obey your parents, honor your parents, obey your parents in the Lord, for this is right. And Jesus Christ is our minister in heaven, our high priest. This is one of the distinctive doctrines that we know. Nobody else has this, otherwise they will be Adventist. Because they can want to know this. And we also believe in Second Coming. No need to emphasize that because we all understand that. Millennium and the sea. Okay. That's the introduction. At least, tapos na lahat. So we will focus on the last day events, the things that are not covered in the introduction. Signs of Christ's return, where is that? In Matthew 24. When shall these things be? We don't know. Jesus Christ said, only the Father in heaven knows. And you might say, even the specific times for the time of trouble, Satan's last, the shaking, the latter rain, the loud cry, the ceiling, the close of probation, the sudden aspect, we are not sure when they are going to happen. Although in this book, it looks like it is in sequence, but it's not, Kennedy herself says, we don't know the real times and dates, but there are signs and characteristics where we will know that it is happening. And probably many of them overlap in each other. But I want to start from the end, because the end is the affirmative, and the end is making us very hopeful. The end says there will be the Jesus Christ coming for the inheritance of the saints. No problem. And Christ returns, and there will be the seven last plagues, and the righteous will be exempted from the plagues, as like what was happening in Egypt. The seven last plagues in the weekend, they will have the plagues, like the what happened in Egypt. The close of probation, no one knows when the close of probation will be. Sunday law enforcement precedes the close of probation. Probation closes when the sealing is finished. What is the seal of God? The Sabbath. We are being sealed because we don't know. They are cooking. You know, in Ukla, you cannot even jump on Sabbath. Why? Sabi ng Presidente. People jogging is sports. No, but you know, it makes us happy. Because if we allow you to jog, and jogging is sports, we should also allow you to play badminton. Badminton is sports also. It makes you happy also. So no jogging. You jog there, security guard will run after you. Probation will close, will end unexpectedly. Human activity after probation close, of course they are eating and drinking. What's wrong with eating and drinking? No. Every time there is a problem in the Bible, there is eating and drinking. I have a friend of mine who started farming. You know? And as you might say, if you eat too much on Sabbath, in the Sabbath afternoon, your mind will be really, I'm surprised, she used this word, stupid. You will be stupid in the afternoon because of eating too much. Think about it on the apple. Unbelief. Yes. The Bible says, SOP appears, but we don't believe. That will happen, pleasures continue. And the video game, oh, how are the video games Adventist? I didn't know until we conducted the evangelism in Kidoro. The pastor, before putting everybody under the water, don't attend, don't go to video game. Oh, ako yung preacher, di ko alam yung video game bawat naman. Oo nga naman, kasi may mga naka hindi masyado modest. Ata, sa likod ng words, di ba? Tapos yung words, hindi rin masyado according to the Bible. Men will hold the interest in business, religious, teachers, the school of, okay, there will be a famine of the world, no more prayers for the wicked, and the transfer of character is not possible. There is no more another probation for the wicked, because even if you try again, they will still not. The seal of God in the mark of this. Ayan, I have to correct some things that are being circulated here. Some people are friends who are good motives, but not have academic preparation to figure out which is bogus science and not bogus science. Some of them, they say that the mark of this is barcode, microchip, etc., satellite, GPS, SIM, new kind of technology. So when I heard this sermon, I went to Doug Bachelor video, I reviewed. I went to Mark Pinty video, I reviewed. It is not according. It is not according to our teaching. I went to BRI, it's not according also. Therefore, I said, let me tell you, it's not technology that is the mark of the beast. The mark of the beast will be Sunday keeping when the Sunday law is enforced, not yet now. Sunday law observance is not yet now, according to last week. So, the problem is that, if they say that barcode, RFID, etc., computer technology is the barcode, we will avoid the barcode, but we will not avoid the disobedience. Diba? Wala ka mga barcode. Eh, pag Sunday ko naman, eh, sunod-sunod kayo. Diba? So, that's the problem. And it's not according, so we are not supposed to subscribe to that understanding. Our friends have good theology background, but technology. Sometimes some people say, yung 666 mark of the beast, you have to say enjoy. But if you read the Revelation 13, 16, and 17, it's the number of a man, and the number of the name, and the number of the beast. So you have to be a beast, you have to be a man, and you have to have a name to be that 666. So yung number of the man, 666, hindi pa rin yung mark of the beast, at saka number of the beast. Because it's not a man, it's not a name. And you are not the beast. If you read it backwards, you have to be the beast first. And the beast described there, of course, is Rome or Papa City. So you cannot apply that number to anybody else. Except the beast. You look for his name, his names, you compute his names, it will sum to 666, it appears the other prophecies about the beast. Okay. About the mark of the head and the mark in the hand. Microchip daw yan ilalagay dyan. Yun din yung explanation. The explanation for that is doing and believing. Okay. There is another explanation. There is another conspiracy theory floating around. We have to teach the truth to contradict this conspiracy theory. Yung heart daw. Yung heart daw ginagamit ng Diyos. Nakalagay dito. Energy White says, natural calamities of flood, water, storms, hurricanes are beyond the control of humans. Ibig sabihin, hindi yan kinokontrol ng US, hindi kinokontrol ng Japan, hindi kinokontrol ng kung sino na sa mundo. As Energy White gives us clue that these natural calamities are beyond the control of humans. They are warnings. So the people will repent. And the angels are holding the winds in the four corners of the earth. So the people will repent until the sealing time is finished. You know. Of course, technically, there are many bugs in their explanation because they don't have any preparation in technology. But we defend it from the writings. Anything that is not according, kaya sabi ko sa mga friends ko, pag wala sa Bible, wala sa SOP, huwag niyo na sabihin. Somebody will prove you wrong later. So, God is the safest. Accordingness is the safest. The loud cry, I think it is happening. I read the characteristics. It looks like it is happening. Our GC spent $1.2 million for Hope 2014 Philippines, Manila. And ngayon, pinapunta nila ako sa Batangas, but inaantok ako. Masyado malayo. Ini-text ako ni Kuya Johnson, ni Kuya Jerry, kapitulo, versikulo, kita ko sa picture, yung Pastor Nunez, si Cesar Fontana, si Sandro Cypher, may blankong upuan. Ako dapat yung mga. Pero, ha? Nandun naman sila. The loud cry, I think, Pastor Ted Wilson, you know the dissertation of Pastor Ted Wilson in his PhD? Evangelism of the cities according to LNG 1. That is his PhD dissertation. If you want to elect somebody who knows something, evangelism, according to LNG 1, the cities especially, you read Ted Wilson's PhD dissertation. That's why I believe God put them there in the right time to contradict women ordination. You know, that is an issue we have to pray about in the church, because some people are introducing things as if it is according to the Bible. But all the priests in the Bible, all the elders in the Bible, all the apostles that God, Jesus, they are all men. When I signed in anti-women ordination, I am with Ted Wilson, I am with DGY. DGY told his secretary, I don't want to talk about encouraging women ordination because it is perilous. The family says, she always says no to women ordination. I'm with Ted Wilson, DGY State. If you want to read more, there is a book, Daughters of God, and appendix there about papers on women ordination. And I'm also with Dr. Clinton Warren, who is Associate Director of BRI. He has a computer science degree. He studied in Oxford University, so he knows languages. And he, of course, has a PhD in theology. So he is in BRI. So he knows logic, he knows languages, and he knows the Bible. And he is there. And of course, Dr. Sinon and Stephen Moore and these people. But there are people who are our friends also in the other side. We have to pray that they will be less emotional and more logical. But this is an issue. But we cannot promote that in church, because the church manual says you cannot promote things that are questionable. So we cannot promote that. Questionable things are not supposed to be promoted here in the pulpit. Only things that we are sure. Okay, the latter rain, of course, the Spirit is the Holy Spirit will do the latter rain. And somewhere else it says the people who did not receive the former rain will not receive the latter rain. Kaya attend lang natin the church. You see, baka dito tumapatak ang mga rain. And then we also have the shaking. Satan's last day deception. I made sure that we review the fundamental beliefs, because the beliefs shield us from deception. Okay, another deception, even inside the Adventist church, lying spirits contradict the scriptures. False revival. Music is made as nail. Oh? Anong klaseng music kaya yung made as nail? You know, there is very one, in, I know in music there are many discussions, but there is only one thing that I know, it is very easy. The only, according to book evangelism, the only music acceptable to God is what makes the heart soft and ready to listen to the message. Okay, if you are making you rebellious and you want to insist on your music, I have some amazing facts. Pag maganda ang music, thank you for the music. Pag pangit yung music, walang sinabi. They have to use educate. But we cannot encourage things that are not according. There will be shouting with drums, music, and dancing. Yung shouting, may mabuting shouting, may masamang shouting, di ba? Yung drums, may mabuting drums ba? Sa Bible, wala akong makita. Sa SOP, wala rin akong makita. Yung music, may mabuting music, may masamang music. Yung dancing, nung doon si David nagda-dance, according to Elijah, the dancing now is not like David's dancing before. Therefore, maganda yung dancing before, but now it is bad, because the dancing now is cha-cha and those things, you know? So that's the summary. According here, bedlam noise shocks the senses. You know, in Elizabeth's vision of going through narrow path, going to heaven, you might hasten. Merong mga music silang narinig dun sa bangin, sa baba. Yung mga hindi mo sila, nararamdaman. You know what kind of music is there? Party music? War music? Yun yung nararamdaman. And then they heard screams. So we should, pati pala yung war music, huwag ko lang nalaman. Ano yung music na according to the Bible? Reverence, solemn, awe, and prayer. There is, in concept in church, all of the programs, should be done in reverence, in awe, and in solemnity. Yung mga yun, hindi mo madidescribe ang bad music sa reverence. Although some rock bands have their own pangalan nila, pag tinan yung reverence sa Google, makikita nyo, may rock band ang pangalan reverence. They try to change the meaning of words. Solemnity. You cannot change the name, the meaning of solemnity. All of the program should be done with solemnity. Solemnity. At saka yung po. Okay. Let us not give okay, you maybe you know that already. First, speaking of tongues, evil angels will appear, Satan impersonates Christ. Okay, let's go to something else. Sunday laws will happen. It will be the great point of issue. There are already Sunday laws in the 1800s, but the angels are holding the wings for that because the ceiling time is not yet finished. God is still waiting for people to repent and join the church. We should not sin and quiet should during not doing nothing. That's why we have religious liberty movements in our church. That is counsel from Ellen G. White, headed of course by John Grass, GC Fire Director, and our communication directors in SSD, Pastor Patronico, Pastor Orbe, and MPC. We should oppose Sunday law by pen and vote. Those who promote Sunday law, let us not vote them. We should oppose them in pen, but not very fiercely, according to the next paragraph. United States will pass Sunday law. First, arguments used on the Sunday law. Okay. Protestantism and Catholicism will unite. Di ba nag-unite siya? Makita niya sa internet. Yung mga evangelical, yung mga Baptist, matagal na pala, 1995 pa. Yung iba, 2000. Ngayon naman yung iba naman. Yung mga, ano na ba yun? Lutherans naman. So, they are not Protestant. Protest is over the law. But God is still holding the wings. Because we have time, we should have time to call the people to the new church. Protestantism and Catholicism act in concert. Sunday laws honor Rome. You know that? Rome will regain her lost supremacy. A national Sunday law means national apostasy. National apostasy will be followed by national ruin. And then, pangandan, Sunday law US. National ruin in U.S. and next universal Sunday law legislation, Sunday law Filipinas. And the whole world will support Sunday legislation. What happens? We should show no defiance. We should refrain from work on Sunday. Para hindi tayo masyadong mainit sa mata. We should engage in spiritual activities on Sunday. And when we are presented to the laws and the councils, bakit ganyan kayo? That is our chance to recite Ezekiel 20 and 22. So that people will understand and some people might believe still. Because we ought to obey God rather than men. Okay. Last, lifestyle and activities of the remnant, spirit of service. We occupy, walang tamad, talaga tama yung sinasabi ni Pastor kanina, hindi tayo aangiling papunta sa langit. We have to occupy till we come. As if each day might be our last. And, ayan, conscientious Sabbath observance. So we told about many things about that already. By the way, si Ellen G. White, nagbibiyahe pag Sabbath. As much as possible, she tried to buy the tickets before Sabbath. But sometimes you cannot do that. So, especially if it's church work, you have to pay pamasahe. You have to buy tickets on Sabbath after the event. One time, they were wanted to reach their destination before sunset. As much as possible, you reach your destination before sunset. But they didn't make it. So, she wrote, we almost made it before Sabbath. Almost. So, almost. Wala akong magawa eh. Ang mga kasadaan, ang traffic ka. So, Ellen G. White says, we almost made it. But I have many friends who are pastors, high demand speakers who don't like to travel on Sabbath and are also vegetarian, by the way. Faithful in tithes and offerings, establishing new institutions, medical missionary work, God's people will value their health. Mabuti na lang si Dr. Tang na pag-bring ng concept sa diet and food. He invested 1 million pesos daw. In case, hindi ko pala nabigyan. Return to the original diet?
Okay,
diyan, original diet. Time for fasting and prayer. Kaya kung nagugutom na kayo, mag-pray lang. Fasting and prayer. Entire trust in God, family worship, regard, associations with the world, and there are recreations that Christ approves. Ano yung mga recreations that Christ approves? The things that recreate, make us stronger. Hindi yung kinabukasan, hindi ka na makapasok. Ano na yan? Sobra na. There are innocent amusements. Ano yung innocent amusements? Yung parang nasasaktan hanggang dami, mga kasiyahan. Parang natatalo. Kaya mayroong article sa Adventist.org. Competitive sports. Ayaw ko nang sabihin pa naman. Yung gusto mo mata, you can research. So we should, there is, those who are office workers, you should rest your mind by physical exertion. It is encouraged. If there is no open area, you use the gym. But it is not the best. But if there is open area, it's better. There is music that elevates, ayan, according to the Bible. The culture of the Bible. The culture of heaven. Yeah. Oh, by the way, if you want to know what is heavenly music, sino nakarinig ng heavenly music? Si Ellen G. White. I attended another conference, attended the opening of E.G. White State in Ayas. And our people from the EGY State, Dr. James Nix and Dr. Jim Tim, they came. In the afternoon, there was a program called Songs of Zion. And what we did, we, Dr. James Nix, researched all the songs EGY and James White were singing. You know why? He wants to copy that. Because EGY had vision of heavenly worship. Ellen G. White had vision of heavenly worship. And in her vision of heavenly worship, she saw the music. She saw the music. She heard the music. And when she finished the vision, she wants to teach that kind of music to her church. So if you want to know what heavenly music is, the debate is finished. Ellen G. White is the only one who knows. So what music did Ellen G. White promote? What music did she sing? What was her favorite hymns? What were these things, these things? Dr. James Nix researched all of those and then compiled it in a book with that background. So the debate in music is finished. Ellen G. White stops the debate. If you want to guess what is heavenly music, read Ellen G. White. Listen to the styles of songs that they are singing. Ellen G. White also says, you should not sing songs of funeral songs. I don't know. Yeah. We should not sing songs of Europe. We should be happy. So when we sang the happy songs, they were all hymnal songs. It's hymnal songs na sinasabi niya rin yung happy song. Hindi yung hill song. Hill song did not see anything else. Gator, yeah, there is gator songs in the hymnal. But we have to choose because gator did not see heaven music. So if there is a singing group that claims to have more understanding of heavenly music than Ellen G. White, I doubt it. Ellen G. White also, when she had spiritual burdens too heavy for her, when she sleeps, you know, as a prophet, we have to rebuke many people. When she sleeps at night, when her spiritual burden is very heavy, she hears the angelic choir singing to comfort her, according to James Nix. And in the morning, she will ask her sons, her family, did you hear the choir last night? Did you hear the choir last night? She's very happy. What choir? She's the only one who heard the choir. And that's the heavenly music. And that's what she wants to teach. So when the congregation is singing, and you look for the words, like this, she will enjoy the tongue in front. Wait, brothers and sisters. I saw heaven in worship. It is not like this what we are doing. They were singing clearly, it can be understood, and from their hearts, let's try again. So they tried again, of course it was better, because the prophet corrected the misunderstanding. If you type the Songs of Zion, James Nix, and Review and Herald in Google, you will find the PDF of the table of contents, which includes all the songs. You look at all their styles, all their messages, and that is the style of heavenly music according to the prophet who saw and heard heavenly music. Dress and adornments, yan, God is restoring the truth. In aiming, hinuhuli, yung mga nakasyon. Very good. Si Sandra Cypher, model yan dati. Pero God called her. Now, when she is preaching, dress reform. Kung magbiklong gabi. Sabi mo, kinakuya dyan siya. Ano yun siya, nasan siya humanap ng dinis? Kasi sabi ng ating mga kapatid na babae, wala daw dun sa mall. Sabi niya, hindi. Dinidesign niya yung sarili niya. Oh, okay. Kaya pala sabi niya, tradition. Ladies know how to design clothes. Okay, dress and adornment. God is restoring the truth to the church. In dress, in music, in food, in Sabbath keeping, because when Jesus comes, there has to be a church which is pure. And wala nang iba yung kundi ang Seventh-day Adventist Church. We need publications. We should not do sharp thrusts in our papers. And we should beware of side issues. We should emphasize unity, not differences. And of course, the Bible says we are united by our beliefs. Martini says the spirit of prophecy unites the church. You know why? Because there are 45,000 other Christian denominations who claim to believe the Bible and the Bible only. So how can we have 45,000 kinds of sets of beliefs? Without the spirit of prophecy, congregationalism Bible. Some people believe not, some people. But because we have the spirit of prophecy, we are united in our beliefs. How to meet greetings? Just ignore them as like Nehemiah did. This is not the word of God. And yeah. Devotional life of the remnant. Those who do not memorize scripture, fill their minds with scripture, will not withstand the test, according to Elijah. So we have to be firmly rooted in the word, molded by the Holy Spirit, the necessity of Bible study. And commit your scripture to memory. And, okay. Some call and believe as if we are being judged. We are in the judgment day. Okay, that is the message for this morning. I pray that you know the church really is. But the financial world, the financial accounting peers to counsel the general conference. They told us, because we are historic accounting conference, all the SST institutions. They told us, you know, the end is near. Not Adventists. Sabi niyo mga accountants, mga counselor ng Adventist Church sa financial. What will happen? Kasi nalugi yung mga tao sa US. Hindi makabayad sa bahay, yung bangko kinasangan, nalugi rin, yung bangko binail out ng government. So they ask the accountants, non-Adventist. So what will happen when the government, US government, falls down? The non-Adventist accountants, according to some class people, sabi nila sa amin, sa kanila, sa mga taga-GC at SSC, you are the people who know the future. Alam nyo kung anong nangyayari pag-ibot sa akin ng Diyos. Ibig sabihin, pati yung mga hindi, mga Adventist, binabasa rin nila yung Great Book of Moses. And alam nila kung anong nangyayari pag bumagsak yung kanan siya ng Diyos. Na kung bigay out niya, ay yung papa. So those are the things that we are supposed to do. Our lifestyle, the signs of Jesus' return, the country living, you know, we are in the country already. We have not everybody can leave the country yet. Because we need schools, restaurants, and churches in the country. When I was wondering, really, U.S. will have the Sunday. Kailan sila alis sa U.S., sa cities in the U.S. But good, the spirit of prophecy has an answer to that. The sign when we are supposed to leave the cities is when they have national Sunday. Yung mga ministers, natin sa cities, sa tayong walang, baka magkakulit yung aking basa. Precipitous moves to the country is not advised. Not all can leave the cities yet. Many in the cities long for light and truth. That's why we have Hope Channel there, and all labor unions, they are Violent. So it says that the signal for flight from the cities, it is when there is, as the siege of Jerusalem by the Roman armies was the signal for the flight of the Egyptians. So the assumption of the power of the part of our nation is the decree enforcing the papal Sabbath will be a warning to us. It will then be the time to leave the large cities. Okay, clear. Sunlight is still in the cities after the death penalty has been passed. Okay. So those are the lights that God has allowed through the Holy Spirit, the message from Jesus, through the prophet, used the prophet Ellen G. White to reach his remnant church. The remnant church, Seventh Adventist Church, is the apple of God's eye. And as prophecy in the Bible is used, when Jesus comes, there will be a church which is used in Bible, in biblical doctrines, in presence, in practices. And the halagayin have to map it. So we praise the Lord for all of these truths, and we pray that God will give us grace and power to live according to the life that was given us.
Pagod po tayo na pag-iimbaran ng ating mga diakono. Pabayayin po basahin natin ang ating kapatayin na pahayag ng General Conference Treasury.